Hello Facebook Ads people. Today I'm going to show you one of my case studies for 2021 where I implemented all of my ideas and all of my different strategies. I had the budget to do it and I scaled one account from 20k to 400k in just 1 month. Before we go there and show you the actual results, I need to point out first of all that this is an old account with a seasoned pixel. And the second thing that I would like to point out is that if you have enough spending and you are having a well-established store, you can always reach me in this email in order to see how we can help your business and scale it also. Let's go to the case study. This account was given to me from one of the agencies that I used to work with in the past, and let's go straight away to the video.
So let's go and let's see this account. It's a very good case study. Basically, throughout the years, I developed a lot of different strategies, which is coming from pure knowledge and by spending a lot of money. In order to be good with Facebook ads, you need to spend a lot of money across a lot of different accounts. So basically, we're having this company that we can see that they were spending, and this is for February 2021, as you can see here, from 1 to 6 of this month, they were just spending 180 per day in one campaign. You can see that the total here, it's 2.2K. Most probably, I have one small campaign running, but all of their spending was just 200 or 200 something dollars per day. And they were getting 2.34 ROAS, a very good account. What am I going to show you over here? It's working not in, of course, we can do a lot of things with new pixels and stuff, but this is an account that it has a lot of pixel data. It's easier for us to actually scale and a lot of strategies and a lot of ads in a good technical, with good technical knowledge. If we make them, they're going to work very well. So, straight to the point, this was the campaign that they were having. I started working with him a little bit because he was hesitant. He couldn't believe that we can scale as much as we wanted. And we were saying.
Constantino, just quick question and just clarification. So at that time that we basically took over their ads, they were getting a 2.34 ROAS. Can you explain ROAS to people out there, just for those that maybe don't know what that means and kind of sure. You know, how important that is?
The return on ad spend is when you divide the number that you, the amount of revenue that you are getting. So in our case, it's going to be 4,850. Okay. And you divide it with the number, the amount that you're spending on your ads. It's ROAS is return on ad spend. So basically, with this, we are seeing how much we are getting back depending on what we're spending. Okay, as you can see here, we're getting 2.34 as much as Facebook says. Okay, so this
that means that we put in a dollar, and Facebook is pushing out $2.34, basically, right?
Yeah, we're taking back in revenue $2.4. Now, a lot of things really matter on this subject. Basically, a company should be able to recognize how they are going to find their break-even ROAS. It's a very important chapter. I also have it in my book. Let me pull it up here. So there's a chapter in my book that I explain how to, here. So basically here, it's a very good way of understanding what is your break-even ROAS. There is an example, whoever is going to get the video, they're going to read this and they can understand immediately how to calculate their break-even ROAS. Because I can tell you that most of the people that I'm talking with, they don't know how to calculate their break-even ROAS after spending money on Facebook ads. And this is going to help them a lot. Okay, so let's move on the ads again. So in this specific case, what I have done is that there are a lot of strategies that you can use in order to scale. Personally, I have developed some strategies with manual bidding and the strategy that I like to call crazy method. In this specific case, I didn't want to just reinvent the wheel. So because the client was also hesitant, I told him that we can use my crazy method strategy and see how it's going to work. So if we go from 7 to 9, I'm starting to doing my scaling. This campaign only is doing 1K and I'm spending as much as he's spending from 1 to 6, I'm spending in this period of the 3 days on my own ads. Basically, first step, it was to start building some retargeting campaigns, of course, okay? He was having a whole structure of doing ads, spending a lot of money from time to time, just when he was going to see some results. But at the end of the day, he wasn't having any retargeting, which for me means that he is leaving a lot of money on the table. So several structures for the retargeting. First of all, we're doing a social retargeting, which is basically a retargeting that we are targeting the people who engaged with the social media. That means that there are going to be people that they're going to watch your ads, but they're not going to end up to your store for many reasons that we're not going to analyze now. But if you don't retarget these people with these custom audiences, basically you're losing them and you're losing money. If they are commenting, for example, or if they're tagging a friend and they are not clicking to go to the actual site, you're losing them if you don't retarget them. Then we are having a long-term retarget. This is a company that is operating for a long period. So I'm breaking down the long-term retargeting in two audiences. They have a very big, a very good post, which is having a lot of video views. So definitely I want to target people that they have seen the video, 95% of the video in the past 365 days. Maybe these people, they didn't convert at this point and they want to convert now. As you can see, it worked very well immediately. And then we are having the site retargeting, which is which started super shy with not very good ROAS, but as you can see later, it really picked up. And then we are having, of course, long-term retargeting that it's for 180 days, last 180 days, the people who purchased, the people who initiate checkout, top 25% viewers based on how long they stayed on the site and all of this. Again, in CBO campaigns, basically spreading out the budget across all of the assets so that we can have very good spending. So here at this point, I'm also starting a campaign with him, which is what I told you, the crazy method. Basically, what I have done is that I told him, I asked him, what was the best ad set that you ever had? He told me that he was having an ad set that he was targeting 77 million people. He was targeting charity and causes and motorcycles. So basically what I have done is I duplicated this specific ad set that was proven that it was having very good conversion rates and results. I have done this, I have done 25 ad sets, okay? So I'm having 25 ad sets and a central CBO campaign, which is actually spending, it was spending much more money at this point, I think. Let me see. I think that this one started with, if I can find it. Yeah, most probably this one started with $300. And after some point, I started closing the ones that they were performing bad. So I kept the only ones that they were doing well. And I let it running with a smaller budget. This is what I like to call the basis. So basically you're doing a lot of campaigns that are going to be the base for what you are going to do later in order to scale. And also you're getting a proof of what you're trying to do here, it's working. Let's see, after the initial week, I work with him with a little bit, you know, trying to make him understand what we are doing. So basically from 9 to 12, we have done 6.5K in spend. At this point, I earned his trust. He was saying, okay, this guy knows what he's doing. So I'm going to spend more money. As you can see, my retargeting campaign started to work very well. I started to do some lookalike audiences based on what was working on the past. And I also, as you can see, starting to do the same way, another crazy method so that I can have a better scaling. I can tell you that all of this has worked very well, but this was the breaking point that that I actually took the whole account and I started working it on my own. So let's see what happened after that. From 12 to 13, and let's go until this date here. This is the point that I started working on my own. Of course, I'm an expert. I started to do my own ads and everything. Here, I'm going to show you a lot of different strategies and a lot of different things that they're working in this account. Apart from doing the crazy method with something that is working very well, either it's one ad set or it's something or it's an ad or a creative that is working very well and you duplicate it a lot of times so that you can have better results. Another thing that that is really very good is doing dynamic ads, okay? This client was not doing dynamic ads. Dynamic ads is this specific button over here. Basically, you're getting a lot of creatives, like a lot of pictures, a lot of different texts, okay? And Facebook is going to blend all of them and it's going to get the best results out of it, okay? Yeah, so basically, can you see that? Okay, so basically it's going to get the best results out of it. And the best combination is going to be the one that is going to win. Let me show you, for example. If we come here and we see the purchases, we see that this one, it's having 26 sales. We can break down the results and actually locate which one of those was working the best. So for example, we can see that for some reason that we're not going to analyze and we don't care, this specific image was working better than anything else. So now we also have a proof of what is working better as a creative or what is doesn't work very well as a creative. Another thing that really worked very well is doing campaigns that they're actually having. So here we're having some cold interests. I have done a very good audience research, finding more interest about his niche. And another thing that it's very interesting is that you can do the same by actually using lookalike audiences and interests together. It's the blender method, as I like to call it. And it's having also very good results because you are having smaller audiences, but they are super focused in the interest that they have been working for you before in the cold traffic dynamic campaigns. Now, all of these, you can do one campaign again and again and again and again, and you are just establishing the small steps that they're going to bring you to the top. Basically, this is what I like to call that it's my base. But after I got the proof of one campaign that is working very well, either if it is lookalikes or dynamic creatives or whatever, I'm moving to my MOB strategy, which is, as I like to call it, mother of bombs. This is what MOB stands for. And as you can see, this campaign in this period, it's about how much? It's about 40% of the budget, let's say, or 35% of the budget. It spent 10K with 3.4 ROAS. It's a scaled number with even better ROAS from what this person had. Basically, my manual bidding campaign is working like a normal campaign, but this time I'm using a lot the attribution model feature over here, the attribution setting in one day after click, and I'm having a bidding of the target ROAS that I want to achieve. It's extremely volatile and extremely difficult to work with people that they don't know what they're doing. It needs a lot of optimization during the day. As you can see, I'm having crazy budgets in the daily, 1.5K, 1.8K. So you have to be very careful with it and needs very careful optimization. But if somebody knows how to do it, personally, I haven't seen it in any other account. It's a method that I developed on my own. It's extremely volatile and it can actually scale your account super fast. And what happened is that actually from Wednesday to Friday, the spend over here is already 38K. So basically we're doing just in 3 days, 38K, which is something that wasn't done before with this account.
And what were they spending before in 3 days on average? What, like $5 to $1,000 in 3 days?
If we go from 1 to 3 over here, they were spending 1K. So
if they got, even if they got a 3 ROAS on that $1,000, so they made 3 grand.
They will get 3K. In our specific case over here with the 38K, if we go only to the manual bidding, they made 37K just by spending 2.13 ROAS. And here in this campaign, they made with 5 ROAS, almost triple, 15. So the manual bidding campaign is working very well. It needs a lot of caring and a lot of knowledge, but at the end of the day, it's working very well. This client is very happy. He's telling me every day that I'm breaking the one record after the other, bringing more revenue and getting record days one by the other. The scaling is very good. We can see that, for example, I'm still scaling, okay? I'm still scaling. We are having at the 17th of February, 11.5K. At 18, I reached 15. And today that we are speaking, the day is not over and we already spent 12 point. You see, I'm just refreshing something and it's, you know, it's crazy. It's like working the, it's like watching the stock market, you know? So basically, yeah. And these are the results today. I'm not even watching attribution model and days, even the results of the day are pure gold. Okay. And I'm still going to do new campaigns and new manual biddings and everything. These are some other manual biddings. As you can see, they're not spending a lot of money. Most probably I will have to try to find, because these are not optimizing based on the value. They're actually optimizing based on the cost control. It's another way of doing manual bidding. I still haven't found for this account what is the sweet spot for this one so that it can start spending like crazy. As I found the value, which is 2.5 ROAS for this account, and it's working very well. So yeah, this is all I want to say. As you can see today, manual bidding is spent already 5.5K already on one campaign, 2.2 ROAS, 12K revenue. Here we're having campaigns that they already spent just one ads and they're spending 1.1.
So they were basically making what, $200 a day, Konstantinos, and now they're making like 10K a day already and it's not even scale all the
no,
way.
No, they make even more than that. I think they make more than, because this account is having a break-even ROAS of 1.3 or 4, I think. So they are making more than 30K per day.
Holy cow. Wow. Yeah, so yeah. That's basically, yeah, that's 300K a month. That's yeah. That's millions.
it's a very big. So basically, imagine that in the previous month, if we go, let's try to see what they have done in January. I'm curious. So they spent 17K, okay? And it was coming from this campaign. So they have earned so basically what they spent the previous month and spending now in one day, let's say like that. Yeah,
they basically spending, 30x their efforts.
Yeah so basically this is what is happening over here and without a huge cost in the ROAS. Okay, so because what I have seen is that we are about 2.5 ROAS so far and maybe they were doing 2.7 by just spending 70k in 1 month, which is nothing. So far this month, for example, and I believe we started here, somewhere around here.
And obviously, Konstantinos, it takes a lot of skills to do all the optimization stuff. I mean, would you say that's one of the biggest things that a lot of clients, they're just not really able to do?
Yeah, the strategies are here. I also write them on my book. But as I say on my book, the optimization is something which is very difficult. And the only way to learn optimization is by spending money. Even going broke until you learn what you have to know in order to optimize, especially with manual bidding. Manual bidding can be super misleading because it needs special care every day. Since you're using very big budgets, you can end up losing thousands in one day, which is going to cause a very big problem in all of your ROAS for the month.
Yep. Okay. So, I mean, most clients, you know, as far as you, obviously you're seeing a lot of Facebook accounts. So most clients are just very basic with their efforts. So so this is just, you know, on a totally another level.
Let me tell you something. So basically, sometimes I think that some things that I do, they're super simple, but apparently since I don't see them in many accounts, it means that they're not that simple and maybe they're just simple in my mind. So after doing a lot of optimization, this is a very good account with a good pixel. Just the people that they have it, they didn't know it. So what I have done is that I have started to analyze where the sales are coming from. And guess what? I did an arrow down based on demographic. So basically I did an open targeting without an interest. This is an answer to the people they they say a lot of times, but I don't have a lot of interest. You know, the crazy method, which is actually duplicating the same ad set a lot of times, and the open targeting that I'm doing here based on the sales of the previous days, it's actually proving that you don't need so many interests in order to fill an account. It's just an excuse that somebody can say that my niche is super focused or anything. If you're having some decent pixel data, you can just analyze who are the people that they're buying. So in our case, it was 35, 65 and only men. And you're having a 56 million audience, which is very good. It's a very good audience to target. So basically you're having zero interest here, and you can do open targeting with my crazy method, duplicate it a lot of times, and then starting closing the bad ones and keeping the good ones so that you can keep optimizing in a daily basis. Yeah, so, and another thing, I'm seeing so many accounts, as you can see, I'm managing many accounts over here. So another thing which is really strange for me is that 9 out of 10 accounts, they're not using dynamic creatives, which I found it super odd. I think that the information in YouTube and everywhere is super outdated, something like doing ads for 2017. And nobody is actually doing Facebook ads with dynamic creative, which is just a simple button to use. And you just mix a lot of creatives together with a lot of copy text. And you don't have to worry about being able to track what is correct or not, because at the end of the day, I think that your opinion and my opinion doesn't matter. Only somebody who is paying, his opinion matters. So what you have to do is give to Facebook the options to optimize, because Facebook is very good at optimizing. Okay, so let's throw all of the images, let's throw everything together with the copies and everything, and then Facebook is going to decide which combination is the best. And this is something that only 10% of the advertisers out there are using. Most probably the people who are watching now, they're going to have campaigns that they're going to have an ad set and just a lot of ads, like 5 or 6 ads. I never guarantee stuff on Facebook, but I can tell you that from my experience, 9 out of 10 accounts that they do dynamic, they have better results from instead of doing one ad set with many ads.
Yeah, we even saw today, Konstantinos, we looked at that account where they're spending $4 million a year and they're not even running dynamic.
Yeah, they're not even running dynamic and they don't even have correct, proper tracking, I guess.
Yeah, so I mean, there's so many things that, you know, people are doing wrong with Facebook
ads. No, and I don't blame anyone, you know, because outside there's so fake credibility outside there with the advertisers, and everybody just claims that they know how to do Facebook ads. And they just don't focus on the technical side on Facebook ads or spending money. I learned doing Facebook ads basically because I wanted to do very good with my own business and e-commerce store. This is a reason that I learned Facebook ads, and then I got hooked. I love them. And this is why I'm trying to evolve all the time with that, and finding all of these different strategies and methods that they're actually super effective.
Okay, so now you can see why I'm proud of this case study. I will try to show you more case studies in the future, not just to show you that I'm good or bad or whatever, but because I think that each one of you can learn something out of these accounts that were scaled and understand maybe or get an idea of how they can scale their own accounts. In any case, that's all I had for you about my case study. You can find me in the email that I provided. You can also find it in the description. If you want to learn more about Facebook ads, you can check my book or read my courses. Links are below in the description. And don't forget that I'm super active on my Instagram. You can always go and check there, because there's content uploaded every 1 or 2 days. And I can also answer in any of your comments there. Until we meet again, be creative and be consistent.